Well, son, that's okay. That's fading up. Well, this is our morning start time here. We got Jack Man in the broom and putting water in the boiler. What's it got, a half glass already?
Yeah.
Wow. All right. These are the cars waiting for us to go out and get them. This is number 7's favorite position, poking his nose out in the roundhouse, getting steam up. And we got 25 sitting out on the shop track. We took the, underneath the plow, they had a flanger blade for the snow in the wintertime. We took that off because we don't need to wear it off when dry weather. So it's been over there getting the flanger removed. This is what the boiler looks like after we hosed her down last night. Got all the soot off there and et cetera things. Plus this stack was just covered with oily sludge. Steve had to put it in a barrel with degreaser. It was so bad. We were really wasting way too much steam oil on it last week. So we're gonna try and watch how we use the valve on it for the lubricator for the valve there. It's getting way too much oil. Chairs that we can sit around in the stove over there, which is kind of cool. Just sitting there looking out the roundhouse. I'm going to go over there and sit in a chair and show you what it looks like going around the other way.
Don't look like a railroad. You get too fucking clean
around there. Hey, you're on candid camera here. Watch your language.
Too late. It's already been moved.
And sit back down here and just stare out. Actually, we got the door closed now. It's hard to see out the what's outside, but when the weather's nice, you can throw the doors open. It's a really neat view looking out the roundhouse doors down the ready track.
Nice.
Huh?
It already is nice.
Well, you can see our water barrels up on top. And you store water in the wintertime in there. So hooks it into the standpipe. That way, don't freeze. There's our firewood supply for.
No, I changed mine.
We changed the hours log down
there.
It's safer.
Well, we're looking at our new couplers. They're weathering. They're steel. And the knuckles are next to them there. So we've got, 45 or 50 pair. Or 45 or 50, I'm not sure if it's 50, I think it's 50 of them. So that'll keep us going for couplers for a while. We got Steve as engineer and Jack is doing some yard switching. Took a load of logs down to mill 3 and they're gonna pull these cars out. We're still waiting for 7 to steam up.
Tom Casper, engineer, Steve Lenz, conductor, Mike Allen's brakeman, Mike's Allen's dad, Harold is riding in the auxiliary tender. And they got a friend named Duncan, friend of Harold Allen. Harold's the old gentleman that has the 4-inch scale chaise. Switching out our train and work extra 7. Well, we're got your settings ready, about ready to go up the hill. Up to 0.2.
Back and forth. Yeah, you did such great, Steve.
Yeah,
I was dealing. Are you following?
Switching out these cars at Woodsville, I gotta be in a certain order to spot them at 0.2. Beautiful day. I'll be 50. That's all he needs, a cop car in the background. You spot one? One for rock loading there, Steve. One for logs and, big chunks of wood in the middle, and then the 438 for the long logs there. Right up to the rock pile. Right across, as close as you can from that rock pile. Even 0.2. Down to Jack's Pit, Grand Chunk's running the westbound, and here rolling by. Somebody can ride with me on the quad back.
Oh, you brought that back?
Yeah. Car leaving. Too bad there's one with a V8. It'd be more appropriate.
Oh, you're going back. You're taking
yeah.
it back there?
I'm leaving that here.
Okay, I didn't know where you were spotting it.
All right. Bye, Paul. The extra board doesn't know. An 8 from a 9.
The only thing is, you gotta ride backwards in the caboose going back.
Yeah, okay.
Well, I suppose we could have wired the caboose, but.
Now you can see where he's been.
Yeah.
Does he want to take any pictures down here? Got his camera with him.
Dad, you want to get out and get some shots here?
Yeah, I will.
It's a nice, sunny, nice sunny spot. We can do a run by down here.
Yeah, that'll work.
I put you...
Yeah, get the switch. I'll write it down.
I'm going to put him in here. Keeps it on the straight that way. Got to go ahead.
Solid than I wanted.
Not quite in a clear. taking a hand out of the throttle. All right, what do you need?
Do I need to sign in going through, or
no,
to
no,
sign
no,
on the card?
No, we won't worry about it. I'll work extra.
Your track spud here. Do you want that left here? I brought
this here. Oh, I'll leave it here. I forgot about it.
You brought the destination Sumac.
I don't see the marker on the right end.
Stop short of the road commission siding. Three cars in the middle. This should be fun. All right. Let's answer it.
That sure don't look like an engineer's hat.
It is. That's in the roundhouse.
Well, you got the wrong hat on, boy. Well, they arrived at Sumac. I make a pickup. Discussing how to do it again. These guys started on the 4%, he stalled. He's got to come up through here, which is 5% right there. 5.2 right here. Dips down a little bit over the culvert and back up to 5% again. A real challenge. Well, here he comes. He's got three cars in a cab. Very good. Keep going, Stevie. Keep going. Leaving Woods Hill. Going back to the junction. Hey, you down, Mr. Lorenz.
Yeah, it just same thing happened to me.
going around the engine, 92 years old. Oh man. Looks nice in the viewfinder. We'll see what kind of light we got. Actually, Grand Chunk's running one. You can hardly make a video without them going by. Yeah, because it ain't going up the stack.
Yeah. Well, for much of going up the stack, we're getting a lot more down here.
And so ends a great day in the Sandy Ridge.
It's warm in the roundhouse, Dad. You want to go inside for a moment?
Get a cramp out of my leg.
Oh, okay. You gotta walk.
I don't know where the heck this. Oh.